Rebel News has a new and exclusive investigation into the cost to Canadian taxpayers caused by illegal migration at the southern border in the wake of Justin Trudeau's infamous Welcome to Canada tweet. 3 years ago, the government was already letting illegal migrants into the country with infectious diseases. Today, friends, we're going to be discussing the health trends of migrants crossing into Canada at what are called non-ports of entry, like the dead end at Roxham Road in Quebec and the bush of southern Manitoba. And I think this is especially timely since infectious disease seems to be on the top of everyone's mind these days. Now, we asked immigration officials to provide copies of any documents showing the costs associated with dealing with those crossing the Canadian border illegally to make asylum claims, including the costs for housing and accommodation, food, staff, transport, tents, fencing, trailers, etc. at the border, and transfers to provincial or municipal governments, and health and medical needs since January 1st, 2017. And we submitted this request on September 29th, 2017. I know, it's April 1st, 2020. Now, what we recently got back was 160 pages of data, and it's so jam-packed full of information that I'm probably going to have to break it all down into three different videos. Please bear in mind, this data is also 2.5 years out of date. It's from October 2017, and it was accumulated in the wake of Trudeau's January 28th, 2017, Welcome to Canada tweet that basically imploded our immigration system with an influx of illegal asylum seekers already illegally in the United States, fleeing Trump's rightful crackdown on immigration from 7 failed states. And even though this data is somewhat old, because the feds didn't want to hand it over to me, I think the situation is probably much worse now. Actually, I know it's much worse. My colleague, Kian Bexty, saw visibly sick illegal migrants crossing into Canada at Roxham Road just a couple of weeks ago. And we also know that Trudeau's changes to the Quarantine Act to, quote, close the border, made a specific exemption to allow sick migrants to continue to cross into Canada and claim asylum. And at the moment in time in which this data was collected, 10 months after Justin Trudeau's idiotic tweet, 13,223 migrants had crossed into Canada from the United States alone at various non-points of entry. So let's get right into this. On page 4, we can see that 43% of all asylum seekers at this point were Haitian. The next largest country of origin is Nigeria. We also learned that the average age of asylum seeker is 28 years old, and 56% of them are male. Then on page 5, look at this. Of those who have had an eligibility interview, 94% have been deemed eligible, and over 80% entered near Lacal. That's Roxham Road. On page 6, on the sidebar, we learned that of the first 11,000 migrants, 22 of them had tuberculosis, and another 410 had less serious health conditions. But don't worry, it says the TB rate among regular asylum claimants is actually higher. Let's stop right here to summarize. Migrants from places that are not war zones, like Nigeria and Haiti, and they're mostly young men, are being admitted to Canada with highly infectious diseases after illegally crossing the border from the United States. On page 7, this chart breaks down the medical services we as the taxpayer have been providing and the costs associated. Again, this is early on, up till June 2017, according to the graph. 127 people got dental services from us, costing $9,600. Over 1,000 got free drugs, costing $27,000. And $300 was spent on assistive devices for the illegal border crossers. In total, we spent $400,000 on free medical services for illegal border crossers by June 2017. So just 6 months after Justin Trudeau's Welcome to Canada tweet. On page 8, we can see that less than 1% of the illegal border crossers awaiting assessments have actually had their health review. And on page 9, we see that even those who haven't undergone a health review have already had health coverage approved for them. Here, to mitigate the potential risk to public health and safety, ministerial discretion has been provided to issue IFHP coverage, the interim federal health program coverage to those awaiting an eligibility review. As of September 29th, 2017, coverage had been created for 6,600 beneficiaries. On page 10, we have an updated medical services chart for September 2017. 917 people were getting free dental care, 4,700 were getting free drugs, 1,000 people were getting free vision care. So just 3 months after the first data was collected in June 2017, the total cost of health and dental care for illegal migrants had ballooned from $400,000 to $1.9 million. In a bright spot, I will note that bureaucrats did reject some claims, about 2,500 health claims, and they were originally calling these migrants, quote, jumpers, which is kind of fun. On page 11, we can see that 25% of the illegal border crossers that arrived by June 2017 got medical services with an average of 6 claims per person. And the numbers would actually be higher because these folks have 6 months to submit their claims. 24 people were deemed ineligible, but were still given free medical coverage anyway. And Quebec and Ontario were bearing nearly the full brunt of the burden for Trudeau's anti-Trump tweeting. Now, I wish I had more current data to share with you, but I probably won't get that until Trudeau has been out of office for 4 years at the rate at which these bureaucrats are turning over information to me. Now, investigations like this are expensive and time-consuming. This one is going on 2.5 years. We have a researcher who helps file these requests and helps us pour through them. And filing for the paperwork and demanding appeal after appeal when the government refuses to turn over the information, well, that can cost a lot of money. And we really are the only people asking these sorts of access to information questions to the government. Now, if you at home would like to support our investigative journalism to hold the government to account for their failures at our border, please go to rebelinvestigates.com. For Rebel News, I'm Sheila Gunn-Reid. Access to information investigations take a very long time and they use a lot of man hours, but sometimes they are the only way to get the truth from the government as opposed to what they say they're doing about immigration at the border. Now, if you think this kind of work is valuable, and I do, I think we're the only people asking these sorts of questions, you can support us at rebelinvestigates.com.